In this video, I'm going to show you how you can build a knowledge graph using an LLM so that you have a visual representation of any subject that looks like this, where you can see the main concepts and ideas, how they relate to one another, and where you can use this underlying knowledge graph system in order to query this field of knowledge and to develop it further. You will be able to use the graph to identify what are the main clusters of ideas inside, how they relate to one another, and also, most importantly, what are the gaps between them so that you can generate new ideas using the built-in AI that can help you develop your understanding of this field further or to also come up with some interesting ideas that no one else ever had. So if you're interested, keep watching and I will demonstrate how it works. We'll be using an application that I developed that's called InfraNodus. InfraNodus is available online, and also we have Obsidian extension, so you can use it in both. But here I'm going to show you how to use the main version. So you need to go to the apps page, and here we have a new mode where you can generate a knowledge graph for any topic. So I'm going to click on brainstorm ideas and explore topics, and then I will start with the topic. In this case, I'm going to build a graph for Chinese medicine. I have a short video on that one, and it was pretty popular, so I decided let's focus on this. And here you have AI-generated sources of content, and I will choose Generate AI Knowledge Graph here. And then I will say that I need, let's say, 30 statements. I will use GPT-4o model, and I want the model to extract entities from it. This is very important because by default, InfraNodus is using words, but we'll use entities. So I will click Generate, and what happens here is that the underlying model will generate several statements in relation to this topic, Chinese medicine, and then it's going to detect entities inside. InfraNodus is going to do that, and then it will visualize those entities as the nodes and the co-occurrences as the relations between them, so you get a really nice representation of the main ideas and how they relate to one another. For example, look at the graph. You see directly that Chinese medicine relates to health, harmony, energy, and so on, so you get like a really nice contextual understanding of the main topics. You can also switch to advanced mode and reduce the number of nodes that's shown so it doesn't overwhelm you at the beginning. And what I like here directly is that when you click on a few nodes, so for example, harmony and energy, when you click on them, we automatically filter the statements that contain those ideas. So you can see very clearly in which context they're used, and you can even generate a summary of those visible statements. So for example, if I want to see what is being said on harmony, energy, and even holistic, for example, I see here three statements, so I can read them and then I will have an understanding of the context. Or I can also click summarize filtered, and then the built-in AI will summarize for me everything that relates to those three nodes, energy, holistic, and harmony. And here I'm going to have a really nice overview of how these concepts fit into the general field of Chinese medicine. So it's also a very useful way to get an overview of any topic. And then what I can also do is when I expand the number of nodes that is shown, I can go into the main ideas tab here, and I have the main topical clusters identified for me. So I can see that Chinese medicine is about holistic health, preventative wisdom, energy balance, integrative therapies, and then there is more topics here, systemic harmony, ecological interdependence. So for example, because I'm interested in ecology, I can click on this topic, see which are the nodes inside, and then ask the AI to summarize this particular topic. And here it's telling me, okay, if you're interested in ecological interdependence in relation to Chinese medicine, here it says how Chinese medicine represents a holistic approach to health that integrates ancient wisdom with modern practices. It focuses on balance of energy, Qigong, alternative pathway to well-being that emphasizes interconnectedness of mind, body, and environment. So this is the relation to the ecological sustainability here, right? So I can really nicely zoom in onto the specific topics and see how a certain field relates to them using this approach. We also have a new feature here. When you click on AI summarize topics, you will actually get a summary of each of those topics. So it's a little bit like the GraphRAG approach, but there you have it directly available to you without having to program anything. So you see you have these six different topics: holistic health, preventative wisdom, energy balance, integrative therapies, systemic harmony, ecological interdependence, and you have a quick summary of each of them, which you can then use to understand this field better. So you don't need to read all those statements, but you just get like a really nice summary of them. Or you can also copy everything, so I can save them to notes, and then I can copy them from the notes here, and then I can use them in any other tool. For example, I can go to ChatGPT and paste it and use it as my context, or into Notebook LM and use this to augment the actual podcast I'm creating, for instance. So you can really integrate this insights into your own tools. So then you can also go to the blind spots here and ask the system to identify the gaps in this content. So for example, here it's saying, okay, there is a slight disconnect between, let's actually reiterate through a few gaps. I like to find the gaps that are further apart from each other. So for example, between ecological interdependence and systemic harmony. And then I can ask the built-in AI to generate a question that would link those two clusters together in a way that they're not linked yet in this text. So here it asks me a question, which I can think of as a prompt for myself or for AI model. So here it says, how can the application of Chinese medicine, holistic and systemic principles focused on energy balance and interdependence, enhance ecological sustainability efforts by promoting a symbiosis between human health practices and environmental systems thinking? That's actually an amazing question. I'm going to save it to my notes. And what I like to do is to think of the answer myself first. So what's the connection between environmental systems thinking and human health practices? And that can already give you a really nice start to kind of start thinking in this direction. But you can also click elaborate here. Make sure that you click focus on this context if you want to focus on this particular graph and to use the wisdom of this graph to generate the response to that question. And then you click on response, and then InfraNodus is going to answer the question that it itself generated for you. So there you can kind of enter into this interactive loop to extract the ideas that you find interesting. And when you find something you like that you're interested in, so for example, here it provides me like a whole summary of what I can do. I can simply save it into my notes here, and then I have a pretty good context here, and then I can copy it again and, you know, generate something interesting from it using InfraNodus itself. So if I click on generate new graph, I can actually generate a new graph from those ideas and then jump into this new context of the ideas I extracted in order to then see how I can develop them further, what are the main ideas inside, and so on. So I kind of really like to use it for ideation like this. You also have another mode how you could approach building a knowledge graph with AI here. And this is a mode where you do it step by step. So you go to brainstorm ideas and explore topics, AI generated. And here you choose step by step AI ideation. When you click here, you can also start with Chinese medicine, like I do in this case. Also make sure you have GPT-4 selected, only the detected entities. And then I click visualize, and then it's going to start with just the graph, right? So here it's going to tell me, okay, I'm generating a set of responses in relation to Chinese medicine. And then it's going to come up with some ideas. So here I'm going to, for example, have some statements that I can read and start with. Maybe I will actually even delete some of them, so I only start with one. And then when I click save in the graph, it's going to extract entities for me. And so this whole process that I just showed earlier on will be more gradual. So I'm not going to add the whole graph from the beginning. I'm just going to add the idea step by step. So I see that there is this connection between health and Chinese medicine. And then there are other nodes like well-being, symptoms, healing. So for example, let's say I'm interested in the relation between symptoms and Chinese medicine. I click those two, go into the AI panel here, select it again to make sure it's selected. So here it says generate content related to Chinese medicine and symptoms. And then I will ask it to generate a response, and it uses this underlying graph structure to generate another statement that I can then use to think how I could develop it further. By the way, if you find those statements long, you can also use the idea mode here. Then it's going to be very short. So if you like shorter responses and iterations, then you can use this mode. Develop a digital health platform integrating Chinese medicine holistic principles with Western diagnostic tools, offering personalized healing plans, focusing on improving overall well-being by addressing symptoms in the context of complete physical, emotional, and spiritual health. So this is more for business ideas. If you like to generate some business ideas, you can use this ideation mode. If you just want kind of more like research-oriented questions that help you develop ideas further, I would use the response mode here. So I'll continue using that. And then here it says that in the nexus of Chinese medicine and its treatment of symptoms, a critical linkage emerged that spans both holistic health perspective and symptom-centered approach. This connection is encapsulated in the notion that Chinese medicine not only acknowledges symptoms as important signals from the body requiring attention, but also situates these symptoms within broader understanding of health that seeks equilibrium across physical, emotional, and spiritual dimensions for overall well-being. So that's actually very nice because it shows me how it's different from Western medicine and how it actually gives importance to symptoms. So I will edit this response and then I will save it to the graph, and then it's going to extract the entities for me. And you see, I'm gradually building something in relation to symptoms in Chinese medicine. For instance, now I have this relation to Western medicine that I explored, holistic approach and so on. So I can now select those two and ask InfraNodus to generate something in relation to that. And there you can kind of do it in a few iterations step by step. You can also not only use the built-in AI, but you can go into the editor mode here and you can just start also writing yourself, in fact, here. So you can say Western medicine, let's say actually Chinese medicine. Medicine promotes holistic approach to health. So you can actually do this process manually and then you click save. And then you see we have this added here, holistic approach, Western medicine, and then Chinese medicine. So we created this connection. And then we can sort of build this graph further by selecting some parts that we find interesting and generating content for them, or using this syntax of wiki links to actually create our own connections here. So this is how it would work if you want to use it step by step. So try it out on infranodus.com. Let me know if you have any questions or comments. And also if you have any wishes for how you would like this feature to work, if you're missing something, if you would like something to be added, I'm always happy to hear your feedback and to get inspiration on how I can make this tool better. Thank you.